A metanode is a node with other nodes inside. Metanodes can be very handy to keep your workflow tidy and proper and therefore easier to understand. Let's take this workflow for example. This node here reads the data. This group of nodes cleans the data. These nodes here prepare the data for the training of an autoregressive model. This block of nodes here trains and applies the model. These nodes rebuild the signal. And finally, this line plot node displays the reconstructed signal. Notice that here there is a column filter pick for node, which produces a flow variable named column name. This flow variable is then reused by this column rename node. Okay, so now let's do some cleaning up. Let's take all those nodes and put them into a metanode, which we will name data preparation. Select all nodes, right click, select collapse into metanode, assign name, okay, and voila, now we have this single gray metanode instead of all those nodes before. If we double click this metanode, the sub workflow contained in it appears in the workflow editor. We can now do the same for all the other nodes until we get a tidy and clear workflow. Once created, a metanode offers a number of options via the item metanode in its context menu. Right-click, select metanode, and here are all the options. Opens the sub-workflow into a new tab in the workflow editor. Then expand goes back to the original sequence of nodes in the workflow and removes the metanode. Reconfigure allows you to change the metanode structure, like adding or removing ports, changing the name of the metanode, and so on. And finally, wrap transforms a simple metanode like this into a wrap metanode. A wrap metanode is also a gray node that contains other nodes. So what's the difference between a simple metanode and a wrap metanode? Wrap metanodes have evolved from the simple metanodes. They can acquire a configuration window via the QuickForm nodes. Their input and output ports can be renamed, and they can filter flow variables from the inside to the outside and vice versa. In addition, wrap metanodes allow for streaming execution, which can improve I/O and runtime. You can create a wrap metanode from a simple metanode using this option wrap, or you can select all the nodes you want to have in the wrap metanode, right-click, and select Encapsulate into wrap metanode. The wrap metanode is a vacuum version of the simple metanode. That is, the flow variables don't automatically enter or exit a wrap metanode. If we execute the workflow now, it will not work, because the flow variables that was created in this metanode will not reach the column rename node, which is placed in this other wrapped metanode. Let's try. Right. So, what we need to do, we need to specifically allow the flow variable to exit this metanode and enter this other metanode. Control double click opens a wrapped metanode. We open the configuration window of this wrapped node output. We then specifically select for this variable column name to exit the wrapped metanode. And then we do the same at the input port of the next wrapped metanode. If we now execute this workflow, now it should work. However, the goal of having a vacuum container of nodes is exactly to keep the flow variables confined in the realm of the metanode they belong to. So it's best practice to create and consume the flow variables within the same wrap metanode. In this case, we should have included the column rename node that uses the flow variable in the same wrap metanode where the flow variable was created. So let's do that now. Now the workflow execution should work without any need to import or export flow variables. This wrap metanode here contains a quick form node. If a wrap metanode contains a quick form node, it automatically acquires a configuration window. The quick form node generates the configuration window of the wrap metanode. Double click opens the configuration window of the wrap metanode. Control double click opens the metanode. Right click opens its context menu. Another interesting feature of wrap metanodes is the possibility to execute the nodes in streaming. So we open the configuration window of the wrap metanode, then we select the tab Job Manager Selection. And here we change the job manager from default to simple streaming. We then set the size of the data chunks to pass from node to nodes. Now execute, and the wrap metanode is executed in streaming mode. We conclude here. In this video, we have shown the main differences between a simple metanode and a wrap metanode.